Elite runner Greg Meyer has come full circle. He ran his way into the national spotlight at the very beginning of the running boom. But he got his start in Grand Rapids. He knew at a young age he was ready to run.
Actually started in grade school over at St. Adalbert's. We were lucky enough, the parochial schools had track teams. But they didn't have a distance long enough for me because I was pretty slow. But when I got to high school is when I started running cross country and track at West Catholic.
When did you know you were good? When did you know you were special? Did you ever have a light bulb moment?
It depends
like that?
On how you want to define that, but stages. Some people know right away.
Yeah.
You know, they look and they go, I'm going to go do this and this and this. I didn't have that. So it was, you know, a moment in high school where someone I trusted said to me, you know, you may get beat this year, but you shouldn't lose anymore. And it was somebody I respected. Wow. And then when I got to college, it was my college coach who, towards the end of my college time, you know, said, you got a lot more in you. You should keep running after college.
Okay.
And that spurred me on. And then moving to Boston and training with a guy like Bill Rogers, who was the best in the world, mm-hmm. elevated your sights again. So it was always being in the right place at the right time. The one thing I give myself credit for is choosing the right people to be around.
Sounds like it.
Yeah, I've been lucky. I've been blessed.
Yeah.
The Greater Boston Track Club with Bill Rogers there and myself and others, yeah. We were probably the best long distance club in the world. We could run against most nations and beat them.
Wow.
And we had a mailman on our team that was running 2:14. I mean, so, you know, a high tide raises all boats.
So 1983, you won the Boston Marathon, and you were the last American to win for a really long time.
Long time. Yeah, those free meals almost ended, you know, but Meb Keflezighi won in 2014, the year after the bombing. And I was lucky enough, that was the first year that I was doing the finish line announcing, so I got to be there and announce him coming over, which was really emotional.
Emotional both ways. Was it bittersweet?
No, not at all.
Good.
Not
good.
At all. You know, the last thing I wanted is to be wheeled out when I'm 80 years old. Here's the last American. No.
Yeah.
It was important for American distance running that another American win.
Mm-hmm. A running pioneer, Greg watched as the sport evolved over the years.
It's all changed. Mm-hmm. It's all changed since the 70s when there was just a few of us out running to now so many people are running.
Yeah. And,
you know, back in the day, we didn't stretch like these guys do now. I watched Dathan Ritzenheim get ready for a workout or a race, and it's 45 minutes of exercise and stretching. We like had a cup of coffee and went out and jogged. You know,
right.
It's a whole different ballgame now.
Right.
I was very, you know, we laugh about it. We truly did live in the good old days in terms of running because we were part of a sport that was being created.
Yeah.
Not like it is now.
All right, so fun things. Do you have favorite gear? Do you have favorite shoes? Do you have a special watch?
Just a regular stopwatch, you know,
yeah.
The old, you know, and mm-hmm. I'm old school that way. Normal training shoes.
Yeah.
You know, I wear Saucony that have mm-hmm. Little medial support because I tend to cave in a little bit.
Okay.
And then just general, you know, nothing fancy.
Yeah.
In fact, I get yelled at by Ken Sung at Gazelle Sports because I still like wearing the cotton t-shirts.
Yeah.
You
say,
oh my God, you got to get into the tech stuff. No, I like, yeah. I like the feel of the sweat on me that I was actually doing some work.
Good.
Yeah.
Think you'll always do it as long as you can?
Yeah, I'd like to. Mm-hmm. I mean, I've got to get more serious about it now. I've sort of let myself get weaned away and I'm just weaning myself back to
yeah.
it now. But yeah, I miss it. What I miss most, running with people.
Do you have a race left in you, do you think?
No. If I go somewhere, it's to have fun and experience the event, not a race.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I would rather just try to run to be fit and, you know, healthy.
Yeah.
Not fit, healthy.